गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट. सो दिस इज द पार्ट 3 ऑफ मोनोटोनिसिटी. इन दिस पार्ट आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन सम इंपॉर्टेंट प्रॉब्लम्स एंड सम इंपॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट्स. ओके, सो फर्स्ट थिंग इंपॉर्टेंट नोट. ए फंक्शन इज सेड टू बी 1-1 इफ इट इज स्ट्रिक्टली इंक्रीजिंग और स्ट्रिक्टली डिक्रीजिंग. दिस इज वन ऑफ द इंपॉर्टेंट नोट फॉर nature of the function, the two, especially 1-1 function. A function f is said to be 1-1 if it is strictly increasing or strictly decreasing. First of all, I want to explain what the definition of 1-1 function. 1-1 function. F is a function from a to b. This function is said to be 1-1 if different elements of a are paired with different elements of b. For example, this is set A, this is set B. F is function from A to B. X1 and X2 are two elements of domain. X1 paired with Y1 and X2 paired with Y2. If these two are different, their images should be different. Then only F is 1-1. Or if these two are identical, their images should be identical. Understood or not? Here what is Y1? Y1 nothing but F of X1 only. So Y2 minus F of X2 only. Means y1 is the image of x1, y2 is the image of x2. The condition for f becomes 1-1. So, if x1 equal to x2, if these two are identical, automatically their images should be identical. Okay, if these two are different, distinct, these two are distinct, their image should be distinct. F of x1 is not equal to f of x2. Then only you can say that the function is 1-1 function. That is the definition. Different elements of A are paired with different elements of B. Then F is said to be a 1-1 function from A to B. So what is given? A function is said to be 1-1 if it is strictly increasing or strictly decreasing. By using monotonicity, you want to decide. Given function is 1-1 or not. For example, see, a function graph is given like this. A function graph is given like this. This is the function. If a function is given, you want to test the function is 1-1 or not. Horizontal line test is there. Horizontal line test. Draw a line horizontally. If that line intersects the graph at more than one point, half of that function is not 1-1. See here. This line is intersecting the graph at two different points. See, this is x1. Say this x2, output is y. Means f of x1 is y, f of x2 also y. So these two are different, but image is same. According to the definition, so given function is not 1-1. Different elements should be paired with different elements. That's why this graph is not a 1-1 function graph. For example, see another one. So this is a graph of a function. I can say this is a graph, strictly increasing function. Okay, draw horizontal lines. So all the lines are intersecting graph at only one point. This line intersecting graph at only one point. This line also at only one point. Understood or not? That's why this function is 1-1 function. Right. Means increasing function. Increasing function satisfies the condition of 1-1. Take a decreasing function. So this is the decreasing function. Okay, draw horizontal lines. All horizontal lines intersect the graph at only one point. Means that this is also a 1-1 function. Means that a function is said to be 1-1 if it is strictly increasing or strictly decreasing. Understood? So this is not 1-1 function. This is 1-1, this is 1-1. The function is strictly increasing or strictly decreasing, then the function is said to be 1-1 function. So here example problem. Let f map r to r be a function such that rule is given. If f is invertible, then find A. F is invertible, then find A. Invertible means inversible. Function is bisectu. If function is bisectu, then only its inverse exists. Invertible means inversible. Means it is a bisectu function. So if a function is said to be bisectu, first of all it should be 1-1 and also onto. Okay, first of all it should be 1-1. Understood? So indirectly what is the problem? If this function is 1-1 function, what values of A? This function is strictly increasing or strictly decreasing. Once again, this is the question. F map R to R be a function such that f of x is equal to some rule. If f is invertible, then find a. Indirectly, what he asks is find the value of a so that this function is either strictly increasing or strictly decreasing. Okay?
Solution for the problem. F of x is given as ax plus 3 sin x plus 4 cos x. It is an invertible function. Such a value one find. Okay. Invertible means 1-1 and add. I want to use concept of 1-1. Is invertible. So f must 1-1 means f is either strictly increasing or strictly decreasing. Either strictly increasing or strictly decreasing. Okay. So I'm finding f dash of x. That is ax differentiation a plus 3 sin x, 3 cos x, cos x differentiation minus sin x, minus 4 sin x. So f dash of x equal to a plus. So already know that how to convert a cos x plus b sin x in single trigonometric ratio. Dividing through by root of a square plus b square, provided a square plus b square is not equal to 0. Okay, root over a square plus b square, root over a square plus b square into root over a square plus b square. If this is taken as cos alpha, this becomes sin alpha. Okay, so cos alpha cos x plus sin alpha sin x means cos of alpha minus x. This is taken as sin alpha. Automatically this becomes cos alpha. You can observe. Okay, sin alpha cos x plus cos alpha sin x means sin of alpha plus x. Like that you can convert into a single trigonometric ratio. So here a means 3, b means 4. Root over a square plus b square, 9 plus 16, that is equal to 5. 5 times of 3 by 5 cos x minus 4 by 5 sin x. So interesting thing is, if this is taken as cos alpha, this becomes sin alpha. You can observe, that is not a big problem. Say this is theta, 3, 5, this is 4 only. Okay, cos theta by 3 by 5, out of sin theta by 4 by 5. This is taken cos alpha, this becomes sin alpha. This is taken as sin alpha, this becomes cos alpha. That is not a big problem. So, what is this here later? Yeah, 3 by 5 equal to cos alpha. So, this becomes sin alpha. So, what happened? A plus 5 cos alpha, 5 times of cos alpha into cos x minus sin alpha into sin x. So that is same as 5 plus a plus 5 times of cos of alpha plus x. Cos of a plus b form. Cos a cos b minus sin a sin b. Cos of a plus b form. So finally I got f dash of x. So by using this f dash of x, I want to find the value of a now. Okay, case 1, f is strictly increasing. Case 2, f is strictly decreasing. F is strictly increasing and f is strictly decreasing. F is strictly increasing means what? F dash of x greater than 0 means what? A plus 5 cos of alpha plus x greater than 0. Okay, Ranana. Or a greater than minus 5 times of cos of alpha plus x. Here, interesting step. Cos of alpha plus x lies between minus 1 to 1. Minus 5 times of cos of alpha plus x also lies between minus 5 to 5. So, your a value should be greater than, see here. This total value lies between minus 5 to 5. Understood or not? cos x lies between minus 1 to 1 na if multiplying with minus y equal alpha again you will get minus y to 5 only that's why minus y cos of alpha plus x lies between minus y to 5 we want the value of a which is greater than this interval we want the value of a which is greater than minus y to 5 greater than minus 5 means greater than 5 only understood so a greater than the value of cos of alpha plus x with minus lies between close interval minus 5 to 5 close interval minus 5 to 5 But what you want the value of a which is greater than this interval. Greater than means greater than 5. So a greater than 5. Means if you take any value greater than 5, this function is strictly increasing. Okay. Now strictly decreasing condition. Strictly decreasing would what? F dash of x less than 0. So f dash of x less than 0. Means what? A plus 5 times of cos of alpha plus x less than 0. Same. A is less than minus 5 times of cos of alpha plus x. Again, minus 5 times of cos of alpha plus means the value lies between minus 5 to 5. But what you want A value? Lesser than that interval. Less than this these values. Less than this value means less than minus 5. Therefore, A is less than minus 5. So what happened? Final A value is what, Nana? Final A value I want right here. Therefore, A belongs to minus infinity to minus 5 union 5 to infinity. For these values of A, this function is invertible. Students, another example problem. What values of x belongs to open interval 0 to pi? F of x, this function is decreasing. Okay, so f dash of x 3 into cos power 4x 4 into cos cube x into inner cos x minus sin x plus 10 as it is cos cube x means cos cube just like x cube 3x square inner x x is equal 1 like that So, 3 cos square x, inner cos x minus sin x, plus 6 into 2 cos x, into this one, 2 cos x into minus sin x, minus 0, constant derivative 0, like 6 sin x cos x common, minus 6 sin x into cos x common, observe here, cos cube x sin x, cos square x sin x, cos x sin x, 6 into 2, 10 into 3 like that. 6 sin x into cos x is going to come. 2 cos square x left here. Here 3 gone to 5 plus 5 cos x plus just 2. Okay. So sin x into cos x. 2 sin x into cos x sin 2x formula. That's why minus 3 into sin 2x you can write. 6 can be done 3 into 2 now. 2 sin x cos x sin 2x. Okay. Into. Now I want to factorize this. So, quadratic, no? Just like 2m square plus 5m plus 2, 2s are 4. 2m square plus 4m plus m plus 2. 2m you can take common here. M plus 2 plus 1 is taken common. M plus 2. M plus 2 can take in common 2M plus 1. So what happened here? The factors are cos x plus 2 into 2 cos x plus 1. This is f dash of x. Now actually you want to find the sine scheme for this f dash of x. First of all, you want to find a critical point where f dash of x equal 0 and f dash of x not defined. So f dash of x equal to 0. Implies sin 2x equal to 0 cos x equal to minus 2 or cos x equal to minus half okay so 2x equal to n pi actually so x equal to n pi by 2 there are several values of x which satisfy sin 2x equal to 0 But restricted interval 0 to pi. 0 to pi, I think n equal to 1. So pi by 2. Only one pi by 2 will satisfy. X equal to pi by 2. in x equal pi by 2, then f dash of x equal to 0. So cos x equal minus 2 never happens, no? Cos x lies between minus 1 to 1 only. So that's why there is no x which is satisfied by this. Cos x equal minus half. Minus half means 120 degree, 2 pi by 3. 2 pi by 3. In this interval, I am saying. Actually, there are infinitely many solutions for this. But in this interval, only one value is satisfied, that is 2 pi by 3. Okay. So we have two values. In this interval, we want to apply sine script for that. So number line 0 to pi. Here pi by 2. Here 2 pi by 3. Now this small interval divided into 3 pieces. 1, 2, 3. So what interval this f dash of x is positive and what interval f dash of x is negative should find. So what should do now? Take some value, any value from 2 pi by 3 to pi and substitute here. In f dash of x. Where is this? Oh, here. F dash of x. Okay, you will get minus. Plus. Minus. Means these values of x, f dash of x negative. These values of x, f dash of x negative. And these values of x, f dash of positive. But what do you want? Decreasing values of x you want. Therefore, I can say for x belongs to open 0 to open pi by 2 union 2 pi by 3 to pi, f is decreasing. Strictly decreasing. No problem. Okay, students. Yeah. Another part of monotonicity. Application of monotonicity. We'll get here. We'll discuss some interesting problems. Okay, so one of the interesting problems is 100 power 1 by 100 and 100 power 1 by 100 should compare. E power pi and pi power e should compare. Okay, so these two problems are based on this concept. Find the monotonicity. Monotonicity. Find monotonicity of f of x equal x power 1 by x condition x greater than 0. Under this condition, we want to find the monotonicity of this function. Okay. F of x equal to x power 1 by x. Provided x greater than 0. Directly I can't find f dash of x here. So I am using logarithmic concept. Log f of x is equal to logarithm of x power 1 by x to the base e. Okay, so logarithm of f of x equal to 1 by x into logarithm of x base e. Another words, log f of x equal to log x by x. Now I want to find a differentiation, or I want f dash of x. 1 by f of x into f dash of x equal to u by v formula. U derivative 1 by x into v as it is minus u as it is. Derivative of x is 1. Okay. By v square is x square. So finally what I got? F dash of x equal to f of x into xx get cancelled. 1 minus log x base e by x square. Now we want to apply sine scheme for this function. So what is this? F dash of x equal to f of x is x power 1 by x into 1 minus log x base e by x square. So number 9. Actually x is greater than 0. This is positive. X is greater than 0 only, no? So this is positive. X is greater than 0, not equal to 0. Greater than 0. This is positive, this is positive. Just we need to find a sine scheme for 1 minus log x base e. X is e. Log e base e 1. 1 is 0. So e is here. Okay. 0 to infinity we need to check. So 1 minus. Okay. For these values of x, this is negative. Observe here. Greater than e. x is greater than e, 1 minus e. That's a negative here. Positive. Is what happened? If x belongs to open 0 to open e, then f is increasing. Increasing. In this interval. If x belongs to e to infinity, then f is decreasing. Okay, 0 to e values function is increasing, e to infinity values function is decreasing. So I will write the solution here, because using this concept only I can solve these two problems. What happened here? In which interval? 0 to e increasing, e to infinity decreasing. Okay students, now I want to solve this problem. Example 1. Compare 100 power 1 by 100 and 100 power 1 by 100, just like x power 1 by x form. Okay, first problem, x power 1 by x form. So I want to solve first problem here. Let f of x equal to x power 1 by x. 100, no? So my x is greater than 0, or I can take e. Because in this problem, x means 100. 100 is greater than e. E means 2 point something. 2 point something. So I can say greater than e. Because I want to use this concept. I want to use this concept. 0 to e is increasing. E to infinity decreasing. No, I want to use this concept. That's why just I took x is greater than e for this problem. Okay. Now, 100 is lesser than 101. F of 100 is greater than f of 101. The reason is, f is decreasing function. Understood or not? X1 greater than x2, f is decreasing function. F of x1 lesser than f of x2. Simple concept. Okay, right here. See, some decrease function is given. This is x1, this is x2. Here x2 only greater than x1. But this is y1 and this is y2. Observe, y only greater than y2. X2 is greater than x1. But here what happened? Y1 greater than y2. Means what happened? X1 less than x2 giving. Okay. X1 is, y1 is greater than y2. Means inequality altering. Means x1 greater than x2 and f is a decreasing function. Automatically, f of x1 should be less than f of x2. Here also, f of x is x power 1 by x. X is taken as greater than e. So, in this interval, function is decreasing. 100 is less than 101. F of 100 should be greater than f of 101. Because f is decreasing. Okay, f of 100 means what? 100 power 1 by 100. 100 power 1 by 100 greater than 101. So, finally what happened? 100 power 1 by 100 only greater than the 101 power 1 by 101. Now I want to express second problem, f of x, x power 1 by x. Okay, here x is greater than 0, but I want to compare e and pi. So, e means 2 point something, pi means 3 point something, e is lesser than pi. So, the values of e more than e values, exactly. E to infinity is decreasing now. E less than pi. Pi means 3 point something, e means 2 point something. Automatically, what I can write? F of e is greater than f of pi. Since f is decreasing. F is decreasing function in the interval e to infinity. F of e means what? E power 1 by e greater than pi power 1 by pi. Okay. Raise the power pi e on either side. So what happened? E power 1 by e into pi e is greater than pi power 1 by pi into pi e. Or I can say that e power pi is greater than pi power e. So e power pi is greater than pi power e. E power pi is greater than pi power e.